Hi, my name is Mike, and I'm an ESRI instructor, and today I'd like to show you how you can georeference imagery that you've downloaded over the internet that has no georeferencing properties. Here we're looking at ArcGIS Pro and a new map that's been added to a project. This map is of a nautical chart that I've obtained over the web on NOAA's Nautical Chart website, and you'll notice it's of the Chesapeake Bay area, not far from where I happen to live. I've assigned a coordinate system to my map of the Maryland State Plane coordinate system. It's in U.S. feet. And here you'll notice this particular JPEG image of the nautical chart has an unknown coordinate system. So we now need to create one. I'm going to cancel this and zoom into the collar of this chart to show you something of importance. These nautical charts all have reference information showing you the latitude and longitude values where this chart happens to belong. So we see this value of 76 degrees 30 minutes west of the prime meridian and 38 degrees 15 minutes north of the equator. What I'd like to do is find the intersection of these two lines and place a control point. Now I can do that by going to the name of my image here in my map, and when I select the image, you'll notice under the imagery tab on the ribbon, we see a georeference button has now become available. When I select this button, it opens up its own georeferencing tab, providing me tools to do a number of things, among them adding control points. So when I select this button, I can now zoom to the intersection of these two lines. I'd like to hover my cursor and place a from point in the center on a pixel. Notice that I can now place a 2 point representing where this belongs on the actual location on the Earth. If you simply right click, you can then see the ability to enter a target coordinate value, in addition, adding values in degrees, minutes, and seconds. So here, notice I can enter in the proper longitude and latitude values. So we've got 76 degrees, 30 minutes west of the prime meridian and 38 degrees, 15 minutes north of the equator. When I click OK, a point is then established. And you'll notice that the chart will now shift and scale and rotate to a location where it comes closer to belonging. So here we see the area in the Chesapeake Bay. I now need to add additional points in the same manner, and we'll have a look at the results. Now notice that I've added 4 control points, and they are properly spaced and dispersed across this chart. As I look at the transformation button, I notice that there are different ways for me to represent my data. With 3 or more control points, I can use a first order polynomial, and this effectively shifts my chart, rotates it, and scales it to fit the proper location. However, it does not take into account the shape and curvature of the Earth's surface. To do that, I'll need to add additional points, second order and third order, to perform those types of polynomials. Also notice there's a control point table button. It lets me see the control points themselves, what their geographic coordinates are in state plane, as well as their residual errors for X and Y. These values are represented in mapping units of feet, and they basically show the amount of difference in distance from where I placed a point to where the software believes that point should go. Once I add additional points, as I'm about to do, I'm going to then improve these values by selecting a second order polynomial. So now I've added 8 control points, again, evenly distributed across this chart, and I'm going to change my transformation from first to second order. Notice the improvement of those residual errors. The map itself also now warps to take into account the curvature of the Earth. We're going to do this one more time and add all of the control points we can find and perform a third order polynomial transformation. So now you see I've added all of the control points found here on this nautical chart, and we can see the residual values listed as a second order polynomial. Notice if I change to third order polynomial transformation, those values will improve, and we could optionally select any that are higher than others and remove them individually to help improve the overall appearance and provide a tighter fit for this chart. When I'm finished, I can then save my work, therefore assigning the coordinates to this nautical chart, so the next time it's added to a map, it'll be placed on the Earth's surface properly. I hope you've enjoyed learning about georeferencing using control points. Give it a try on your own, see how you like it, and I also hope you've enjoyed this video. Thank you.